And there's our prism, the starlight's shining through, and there's its spectrum.
Gizmos is a great way to get students involved in inquiry learning.
My first impression was how fantastic.
It shows teachers what the standard really looks like.
The students get to have a sense of, I really am a scientist. I'm trying to figure out what's going on here.
And on this gizmo, you have a ramp.
It was a little over a decade ago, and we were working on a math and science implementation grant in the district. I instantly saw the value of what gizmos could bring to our district and grew it into an established program.
Increases the magnitude of friction.
I needed something to focus on friction without having me to get all the different materials and bring the materials into the classroom, because I don't know where I'm going to find a rubber ramp or a steel ramp, or I could make a wood ramp, but they're not easy to transport in the classroom. And by having the gizmo, I'm able to have them experience that.
So how well does rubber do on an ice ramp?
It leads students into some metacognition in the hands of a teacher who really wants to engage in inquiry.
We have a spectroscope model right up here.
My initial thought was to find a lesson that matched the needs of fifth grade students who are going to be going to our STEAM Center.
And see if any of these prominent lines match.
It's not a matter of me really always being a teacher as much as a facilitator.
What did we notice? What was in Star 2?
It's a good place for them to try things and experiment. If there's a standard that's really hard for you to teach, you can find a gizmo generally that will fit into that standard.
With a simple drop down, our teachers can find their textbook or sort by standard.
You're gonna make a claim about this particular gizmo, maybe about the bears, maybe about the deer.
We're working on ecosystems right now, and the forest ecosystem was a really nice way of showing that taking something out of a food chain changes the entire ecosystem.
It increased quite a bit, didn't it?
Yeah, without the bears.
And because they could see it and they could do it year by year by year by year, that means more to them than if I just tell them that, you know, over time something's gonna happen. To them, that doesn't make any sense.
Some people think, oh, you just put the kids on gizmos and let them go, but you don't. It's a guided exploration.
I really found value in the exploration guide. It's scaffolded enough and directed enough that if the students follow that exploration guide, it's gonna lead them to some discoveries just by the way it's set up. They can explore things that we would never be able to bring to them.
It's a good place for them to try things and experiment.
They're asking deeper questions about sources and data and where information's coming from.
It kind of gives them a chance to kind of be that little mad scientist that they all kind of want to be. We all want to be.